Welcome in to Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton.
People say I am the best boss. They go, God, we've never worked in a place like this before. You're hilarious.
News, weather, sports, and of course, all the local info you need to start your day.
I think that pretty much sums it up.
Talk of the Town live on 103.7 WTIB.
What?
Cable 7 in Greenville and worldwide at WTIBFM.com.
What?
Now here's the host for Talk of the Town.
Yes.
Henry Hinton.
Hey, welcome in everybody. Hour 2 of Talk of the Town here Monday morning, November the 19th. Good to have you here. Trent McGee's here live with me in the studio. How
good
are
morning,
you, sir?
I'm fine.
Nice to see you. You know I'm going on vacation tomorrow.
I heard.
I'm leaving you the keys to the house and the keys to the car, and I don't expect you to screw it up.
I'll put my feet up, relax.
Yeah, exactly. You and Engelbrecht and Weaver, I'm scared to death.
Oh, we can hold this thing down for two days at least.
Welcome into Monday. Welcome to Thanksgiving week. Also, no WITN person this morning, but in the studio, in the control room this morning, Michael Buscemi, our producer. Good morning, Michael.
Good morning.
How are you? Nice to see you. And just in from Baltimore, Coach Neil Carr, who went to the Ravens game last night. He told me during the news break that he went to the Ravens game and got back to Greenville about 3 in the morning. Was it worth it?
Yes, it was. The game was awesome. The first round draft pick, Lamar Jackson, the quarterback.
Yeah.
He also a Heisman Trophy winner.
Yeah.
He got his first start against Cincinnati.
You hate Joe Flacco, don't you?
Yes, I do. I do. I hate the way he plays. I'll put it that way. But I'm happy that we have a quarterback now like Cam Newton.
You think?
Absolutely. He can run. He can throw. You know,
That could change the dynamic of that team. They've been missing a little something. That might give them a spark.
Yeah, it did. Yeah. The whole stadium were like – very, very high tempo. It was energetic.
You loved it, didn't you?
Yes, it was awesome.
Ray Did you Lewis get lost on the way back?
I'm sorry.
Did you get lost on the way back?
No.
He was partying, man. He was out on the field trying to tear the goalpost down, you know.
Yeah.
3 a.m., you were there for a while. The game was at 1 o'clock.
Look, don't ask Coach what he does in Baltimore when he goes up. That's very private.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah,
you know, I've noticed that when he goes to Baltimore on the weekends, which, you know, where's his old stomping grounds, that – he stays up there pretty late some nights. I think there's something going on. I'm not.
Well, I lived there for 31 years, so I know where to go and who to see.
I know where to go.
I know
where to go.
I don't know what that means.
You probably I'll tell you during the break.
Yeah, you probably know where not to go, too, is my guess. All right, well, it's good to have you back. I'm glad you got back safe. I went down the hall and was visiting with the 107.9 morning team. Mark and Laura, Mark Miller, Mark Pascal, and Laura Smith. And, of course, what do you think the subject matter was with Mark Miller this morning?
Food.
No, it's not. No, that would have been Pascal. No.
The Eagles.
No, Pitt football. He went to the University of Pittsburgh, and he went over to Winston-Salem over the weekend and watched Pitt beat Wake Forest. And I thought to myself, wow, I would rather watch a pillow fight with my grandchildren. Pitt, Wake Forest.
Yes, and Pitt's won the Coastal.
And
right?
he was like, and Pitt won the division, and they're going to play Clemson in the ACC tournament, in the ACC championship. That will be such a beatdown. He's going that game is December 1st in Charlotte. He says, I'm going. Can you help me get parking? Can you help me get tickets? You know, I'm like, why would anybody want to go see Pitt get the bejesus beat out of him by Clemson? But it just kind of shows you where the AC – good job, John Swofford. Just kind of shows you where the ACC is. The ACC championship game will be Pitt and Clemson. This is not the ACC I grew up with.
North Carolina beat Pitt.
I know.
And Pitt's in on the top 25.
Pitt is North Carolina is 1-6 in the ACC. Pitt is 6-1. Guess who beat them? The Tar Heels.
Yeah.
Tar Heels got a big win over Western Carolina on Saturday too, didn't they? Yeah, is that the last win of the Fedora era?
I don't know. Can they beat NC State this weekend in Chapel Hill? Wouldn't surprise me.
You think they can beat State?
No, I don't, but it wouldn't surprise me if they do.
See, I think when you got these games, NC State, East Carolina, Carolina, NC State, I think particularly when NC State is one of the teams, I think all bets are off. Doesn't matter what the record is, which is why I think ECU actually has a chance to win the game in Raleigh in a couple of weeks. I know people think I'm crazy when I say that, but I mean, if they play, look, I think Holt Naylor's got a little confidence, a little spring in his step after a Saturday night, don't you? He was spectacular.
Oh yeah, I know I would.
I know the UConn defense is not good. I was talking to Coach Logan on Saturday morning before he went on the radio, and I said, I'm worried about ECU, you know, and UConn. He said, let me tell you something, Henry. I watched UConn on film. That is the worst defense in the history of college football. Okay, so David Kuhn, the only Wake Forest fan in the listening area, just said, how did ECU do against North Carolina A&T? Kuhn, that was a low blow. Why would Kuhn have to do that?
Well, you can't knock his Demon Deacons and not expect to get knocked back.
I don't know. ECU basketball tonight. Who is it they're playing? They're playing that Rio Grande team?
Yeah. University of Texas,
out of
Rio
the plains,
Grande Valley.
Well, of West Texas.
Riding in on my horse in UTRGV.
Who is the team we're playing tonight?
Texas, Rio Grande Valley.
I have an announcement to make. Jeff Charles has laryngitis. Doing play-by-play tonight on the Pirate Sports Network, the IMG Pirate Sports Network, our own Patrick Johnson, who, by the way, does a great job calling play-by-play. So I'm looking forward to hearing Patrick do that tonight. He'll be working with Cy Seymour tonight.
Jeff?
In fact, Cy's going to be on the afternoon show with him on 94.3 The Game today.
He didn't sound good during the game this
weekend. No, I was listening to the post-game leaving the game Saturday night, and Jeff's voice was about to go then. Yeah. And then I watched some of the TV show with Coach Moe yesterday, and Jeff's voice and Coach Moe's voice was about to give way. I guess it finally went. So this morning, Jeff has got laryngitis, and so tonight's basketball game will be Patrick Johnson calling the play-by-play, our own PJ, who does a great people may not know this about Patrick. Patrick has been doing television play-by-play for years on the Masson Network for mm-hmm. some of the CAA games. Particularly, he's kind of been the guy that they've always used for the UNC Wilmington games.
Mm-hmm.
But if you've heard him do the Rose High football games here on 94.3 The Game on Friday nights, you know he does an excellent play-by-play.
Oh, yeah, he'll be great.
So I'm looking forward to hearing Patrick tonight, and I hope Jeff will heal up soon because I tell you, his voice sounded tough on Saturday night.
It did.
Let's see. Speaking of high school football, Rose High lost on Friday night.
They're out.
And South Central won, right?
They had a bye.
I think there's discussion about us carrying South Central's playoff game coming up on Friday night. Have you heard that on 94.3?
I have not. No, that's news to me.
So you can announce that tomorrow. I guess that determination will be made today.
It's news to me.
So that's another great season of Rose High football on 94.3 The Game. They had a great season, and we appreciate being a part of their the whole deal with them this year. All right, let's see. What else do we have? There were some other things I wanted to mention in our opening here. I mentioned that the Embers show is coming up on December 9th. I'll give you the details about how to get tickets on that. If you have not gotten your tickets yet, you need to do that. Here's something that came up over the weekend that I was unaware of. Bev Perdue, the former governor of North Carolina, has just been named. Whoops, this is the wrong article. What happened to that? She's just been named chairman of a national committee. That why is that story not coming up? Wow,
it was a few weeks ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, I'm trying to. There's an article on Lady Liberty today, and I'm hitting my link here, and for some reason it's taking me to another link. Something's wrong with the link. It's taking me something from June 30th of 2012. How does that happen when things like that go?
It's a throwback Monday.
All right. Well, anyway, tell us what's happening weather-wise this week, and I'll look for this article. How about that?
Yeah, it's looking good. After the rain clears out for today, we'll see plenty of sunshine our way on Tuesday with highs in the mid-60s. And then Wednesday, sunshine back in the forecast with a high of 54. Lows both nights in the low 30s, or I should say upper 30s. And then your Thanksgiving Day, Thursday, looking really good. Plenty of sunshine, highs in the mid-50s, and lows in the low 30s. So looking good, really, for the rest of the week. We'll see rain back in the forecast again on Saturday and maybe a slight chance of rain on Sunday.
All right, I found the article. Got to the right link finally. Beverly Perdue has been elevated from a member to chair of the organization and chair in charge of the nation's education report card, commonly known as the NAEP. Now, according, this is on the Lady Liberty website this morning. And she says her Common Core fanaticism and her ties to the Gates Foundation are probably why she was elevated to the chair. NAEP scores have been flat and most recently falling. The barbarians will be at the gate soon. But let's take a walk down memory lane on why former Governor Perdue is not someone you want out in front leading your parade. And then she goes through all the list of things. 2009, Perdue ordered a 5% pay cut for all state employees and furloughs in some cases. Remember that? In 2009, Perdue helped double murderer Sally Holloman be paroled because she did a good job on work release for then Lieutenant Governor Beverly Perdue. 2009, this was one of my favorites. She used lottery funds. Remember, we were told when the education lottery was passed in the legislature just a year or so before that we'll never use these funds to balance the budget of the state. All of this money will go to the kids and education. And then like a year later, she took education lottery funds and balanced her budget. Instead of cutting spending, that's where she went. And then my personal favorite, in 2011, when Perdue called to suspend the election. Remember that? She said, we need to suspend the elections. She said at an event in Cary, she said, I think we ought to suspend perhaps elections for Congress for 2 years and just tell them we won't hold it against them, whatever decisions they make, to just let this country recover. That's right. The former governor of North Carolina said we should suspend elections. So all of you people who think Trump says dumb things. You know, I always felt like she got out just ahead of the scandals that were getting ready to break. There were a lot of things coming up in the media that she was able to kind of escape. Yeah. 18 minutes after 8 o'clock, let's get a break in. It's Monday morning, the 19th day of November. We got the turkey trot coming up here in Green. We're going to talk about that.
That's always fun.
You know what? I've done the turkey trot a few years, and the weather's going to be great for it, I think, on Thanksgiving morning. So, and you know what? Rather than sit around and, you know, you're going to be eating a big lunch that day. So instead of that, you need to plan some exercise that morning. You might as well do it, help raise some money, and get out and enjoy
it. I watch them come through every Thanksgiving, yeah.
You watch them? Why don't you get out and do it?
I should.
I remember doing it. I did like 4 miles. Like 3 years ago, and I was the last person, but I did finish.
That's all that matters.
The turkey trot, I'll tell you about that coming up, 19 after 8.
Get year-end savings now at Greenville Toyota. Corollas, $159 a month. RAV4s, $199. The wait is over and the deals won't last. It's the year-end savings event at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
All right, everybody. This is our team. This is our house. Now let's go out there and have some fun. Ready?
Right!
Hi, I'm Luke Keekley. And just like my team, Pepsi was born right here in the Carolinas. This is our home field,
and Pepsi is dedicated to making a positive impact in the communities all across our two great states. So here's to our house, the Carolinas.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
Carolina's greatest hits play all day on 107.9 WNCT.
Don't stop believing. Give it all a prayer.
All your favorites. With Mark, Mark, and Laura in the morning. Carolina's greatest hits play here.
WNCT.
You waited for year-end savings. Now it's finally here at Greenville Toyota. Camrys, only $179 a month. You don't want to miss these deals. Camrys, $179 during the year-end savings event at Greenville Toyota.
Question, what will you find on all over-the-counter or OTC medicine packages to help you choose the right drug and use it safely? The answer, the Drug Facts label. This label lists the medicine's active ingredients and purpose, how much to take, and warnings you should know before using it. Remember, even OTC medicines you buy without a prescription can cause side effects you don't want. So follow the information listed on the Drug Facts label. For more information, visit fda.gov/drugfactslabel. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
After 8 o'clock, talk of the town here on Monday morning, 19th day of November. Going to be, sun's going to finally come out probably around lunchtime today. Kind of a messy morning if you're driving in eastern North Carolina. I had to use my windshield wipers coming in for the sprinkles. So I'm sure that some of you are having to do the same thing. But it's going to clear up and going to be nice the rest of the week. Sunshine, temperatures in the 50s most of the week. Might get 60 here and there. Tomorrow's going to be, today and tomorrow, both in the 60s, but we get down toward Thanksgiving, going to be nice and sunny and temperatures in the 50s. I'll check the full forecast for you coming up in just a minute, but first let's check some news headlines now. No WITN anchor in this morning, so Trent McGee will do the honors. What's happening, McGee?
All right, Hannah. Pitt County man is being held this morning under $1 million bond after police say he tried to kill someone earlier this month. 23-year-old Malik Johnson of Winterville was arrested by Greenville police on Friday and charged with attempted murder. No additional information is currently available now. Johnson is being held at the Pitt County Jail and is expected to appear before a judge this morning. The Coast Guard ended its search for an 83-year-old man who went missing this weekend in Edenton Bay after finding a body Sunday afternoon. After searching about 325 square miles by water and air near Edenton for nearly 24 hours, search and rescue crews found the body around 4:30 Sunday afternoon. The man was originally reported missing Saturday at 6:30 after his wife said he did not return home from a fishing trip. A man is facing charges after a high-speed chase across multiple counties. Goldsboro police say they caught a group of sports cars racing shortly after midnight Sunday on Highway 70. Officers tried to pull them over, and one driver refused to stop, leading officers on a high-speed chase along Highway 70 westbound. Authorities eventually deployed a tire deflation device to stop the driver near Caps Bridge Road. They say he reached speeds over 150 miles per hour. Mark Crabtree, 29 years of age, of Chapel Hill, was arrested and charged with careless and reckless driving. Online records show he has been bonded out of Wayne County Jail. The driver involved in a fatal Pitt County crash Saturday night was charged after Highway Patrol troopers say she ran a stop sign. The crash happened just before 7:30 on Highway 43 after a Buick sedan exiting, the off-ramp of U.S. 264 failed to stop at a stop sign before turning onto Highway 43. A Mercedes SUV traveling southbound on the highway hit the car. The car overturned and landed in an embankment while the SUV overturned along the median of the highway. 61-year-old Jenny Sessoms of Tarboro was in the front passenger seat of the car and was pronounced dead at the scene. 54-year-old Angela Edmondson, also of Tarboro, who officials say was her best friend who was driving the car, has been charged with misdemeanor death by a motor vehicle. The driver of the SUV was transported to the hospital but later released with no injuries. Edmondson did have some injuries but is expected to be okay. And state troopers are stepping up their patrols ahead of the long holiday weekend. They say troopers will be stationed every 20 miles along I-40 starting Wednesday. According to AAA, Thanksgiving is one of the busiest travel days across the country, with 1.5 million North Carolinians expected to travel 50 miles or more. Traffic is expected to be the heaviest starting Wednesday and lasting all the way through Sunday. Henry?
All right, very good. That is our news update. Let's check our weather now. It's going to be cloudy and showers before noon today. And then after that, things will clear up a bit, and it's going to be nice kind of the rest of the week. Temperatures today are going to hit maybe the low 60s, and then overnight tonight into the upper 30s. And then on Tuesday, sunshine, high temperatures in the mid-50s, and overnight lows tomorrow night in the 30s. On Wednesday, sunny skies, high temperature 55 degrees, and lows in the 30s again Wednesday night, Thanksgiving Eve. And then on Thanksgiving Day, sunshine, very nice, temperatures in the mid-50s. Going to be a really nice Thanksgiving Day. And really on into Friday, no chance of rain at all after today. The next chance of rain will be on Saturday, where we've got about at this moment, about a 60% chance of rain. Temperatures back up into the mid-60s. Current temperature outside the Radio Ranch here is 50, and temperatures down toward the coast, 53 now in New Bern, and it is 53 also in Jacksonville at 26 minutes after 8 o'clock. News and weather, a service this morning of the Tire Realty Group and Property Management Team. Great time over there on Friday. A lot of great pictures on Facebook over the weekend.
I saw them. Yeah, they were really good.
We had a great time at the ribbon cutting and grand opening of the Tire Realty Group. Thanks to Homer and Rachel for having us over on Friday. And if you hadn't seen their beautiful offices yet, I'm sure they'll give you a tour if you want to stop in. Tire Realty Group, of course, the home of the 99-day guarantee. They guarantee they'll sell your home in 99 days. And if they don't, they take no commission. There's never an upfront fee, and you can fire them at any time and pay them nothing. They're the only firm that gives you a get-out-of-jail-free card. If you're not satisfied for any reason, you pay them nothing. There's no penalty to cancel the listing agreement. And as always, they're looking for career professionals in sales. We met a lot of their folks over there on Friday morning. What a great group that they've got at the Tire Realty Group. So list your home today, sell it quickly, get top price for it. As you heard Homer say on the program on Friday morning, real estate market's still very hot, although it might not be quite as hot as it was 6 months ago, but it's still pretty good. This time of year, things will cool off a bit as we go into the holidays. But list your home now. And they also will sell your home. Tire Realty also has a property management division, and they lease homes as well. So call them today at 758-HOME. Visit them online at 99orfree.com, the Tire Realty Group. All right, 28 minutes after 8 o'clock, welcome into Monday morning. And coming up next, we're going to find out about the Greenville Turkey Trot. Get out on Thursday morning before you start eating the turkey and get a little exercise. We'll be right back.
Save with low monthly payments on new Jeep here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
It's the Black Friday sales event. Lease a new 2019 Jeep Cherokee for only $299 a month. With only $299 due at signing. Lease a new Jeep Grand Cherokee for only $399 a month. With only $399 due at signing. Or lease a new Jeep Wrangler for only $399 a month. With only $399 due at signing.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Carolina's greatest hits play all day on 107.9 WNCT.
Don't stop believing. Oh, damn it, I'm a prayer.
All your favorites.
Just like the ocean,
with Mark, Mark, and Laura in the morning.
Up and go, you're
Carolina's greatest hits play here.
WNCT.
This is the Pepsi for serious fans. Mmm. And serious eats. Oh, yeah. Like Carolina pulled pork, carnitas,
or Alberto's Al Pastor.
Nice, Beto.
This is the Pepsi for Sundays at the ballpark and days off at your favorite joint. Whatever you're craving, this is the Pepsi for you.
Stop by Moore's Old Time Barbecue and grab a Carolina Classic combo with a free 20-ounce Pepsi. Moore's Barbecue and Pepsi, Carolina Classics indeed.
How I define making? In the broadest possible terms, it is making something extant in the world that didn't exist. Everybody who's ever made anything is bringing something into fruition for a reason. And that act in and of itself makes us stewards of our culture. It's something that we're talking about. It's a response. Actually, it's telling a story. That's really what it is. And I include everything that could be made, painting, sculpture, welding, all of that.
Yellow is positive.
When a kid gets their hands on the world and learns that they can make their fantasy play, that they can make their reality, that's power. And as far as I'm concerned, everyone should feel that kind of power. There we go. If there's something that interests you to bring into the world, that's fantastic. Go figure out how to do it. Go tell your own story.
There it is.
And so I want to know why you make. Let's go.
Share your own Why I Make story today. Visit whyimake.org.
Come check out the all-new 2019 Ram. We have a huge selection to choose from here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Hurry in to the Black Friday sales event for huge rebates and super low lease payments on Ram trucks. Right now, get a total savings of $12,659 or lease a new 2019 Ram 1500 Crew Cab for only $379 a month with only $999 due at signing.
I'm here. Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Town, talking to town at 8:32, 28 minutes in front of 9 o'clock. A lot of sports over the weekend. We mentioned Coach Carr and his visit to the Baltimore game yesterday. And, of course, the Pirates with a big victory over UConn on Saturday night.
Got a tough one this week.
Yeah. Have they announced the time for the Cincinnati game?
3:30.
3:30 on Saturday?
3:30.
Is that on TV?
It is. CBS Sports Network.
All right, so I'll be in Florida. I'll have to see if I can find that. Probably have to go to a sports bar.
Probably.
Like I did in Costa Rica last year. But how about, have they announced a time and a, is the game at NC State going to be on TV?
It's a 12 noon game. I think it's the ACC Network, if I'm not mistaken. I need to double check that.
Huh. All right, well, you can check that later. That's a couple weeks away.
Yeah.
But this week, it's the Pirates in Cincinnati, and the Pirates are coming off the big win over UConn. And, of course, the big news yesterday was the loss by the Carolina Panthers and Ron Rivera's decision to go for two. I like the decision. You didn't like it.
I didn't. No, I thought if they, you know, they were playing, I shouldn't say they were playing well enough. First of all, let's go back and look at that game. Numerous drops by Devin Funchess in the game. The missed field goals by Graham Gano. I thought Cam played really well. They couldn't run the football, so they really dug a hole deep and had to claw their way back. But I thought if they were able to tie it up, take it to overtime, take your chances, and maybe knock them off that way. I just didn't – I didn't like going for the win there.
Well, I kind of like when you're on the road, you go for it.
I understand it. I do. But
that's kind of my philosophy.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad that's Rivera's too.
I'm glad I don't have to make those decisions. But Cam missed a wide-open receiver, kind of like the end of the Maryland Ohio State game.
Oh,
did you see that?
Yes.
Talk about an open receiver to win the game.
He had him.
Yeah. All right. 8:34. Here's McGee on sports.
Yeah. The Lions held off the Panthers 20-19 on Sunday. Cam Newton connected with DJ Moore for an 8-yard touchdown to pull the Cats within one with 1:07 left in the game. Carolina goes for two and the win, but Cam Newton's pass to Jarius Wright was incomplete, giving Detroit the one-point win. After the game, Panthers head coach Ron Rivera on his decision to go for the win.
Well, I think you go for two on the road to win the game.
And that's what I did at the end of the day. Was to say the coin toss is going to go in our favor, was to tell you we're going to slap them. So why not go for two? I was going for the win. That's just the bottom line.
Panthers fall to 6-4 with the loss and will host the Seahawks on Sunday. Other scores from week 11, Saints crush the Eagles 48-7. Steelers rally to beat the Jaguars 20-16. Texans get by the Redskins 23-21. In that game, their Redskins quarterback Alex Smith broke his right. Did you see this?
You know, I looked at the video and I had heard how gruesome it was, but I couldn't see that it was really, I couldn't tell that you, maybe that the shots I saw.
It turned the other way.
It was kind of like a Theismann moment.
Yeah. Yeah. Who was at the game?
Yeah. I saw Joe Theismann actually tweeted.
33 years to the day.
And by the way, I thought it was great that both teams. It shows you what kind of respect Alex Smith has. I've told you before, I'm an Alex Smith fan.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
I liked him when he was out in
San Fran.
When he was out in San Francisco. Mm-hmm. By the way, speaking of San Francisco, now that Alex Smith is out for the season, there's talk about them bringing somebody in
by the name of Colin.
They're actually looking at who's the guy that the Jets was it Santos.
Geno Smith?
What was his name? The Santos guy. What was his name?
Sanchez.
Oh, Mark Sanchez.
They're talking about bringing Sanchez in. Not going to bring in Colin Kaepernick.
Ooh.
I don't blame him.
Ooh.
I don't blame him. I wouldn't bring that guy in my locker room either. Mm. But that'll be another big controversy, right?
It will be.
Because, you know, I read this morning that Kaepernick is the best available quarterback for the Redskins. I'm not sure that's even true. Do you remember how horrible he was the last year at San Francisco? He was horrible.
Sanchez, though. That could be just as bad.
Well, Sanchez might be started lose, for lose the Jets. For that's not saying much.
Yeah. Cowboys beat the Falcons 22-19 and the Ravens over the Bengals 24-21. Tonight, a huge game in the NFL, matchup of two of the league's best as the 91 Chiefs visit the 91 Rams in a game that was originally scheduled to be in Mexico. That game now will be there in L.A. ECU opens a three-game homestand tonight, welcoming Texas Rio Grand Valley. Tip-off set for 7 o'clock from Minji's Coliseum. Our own Patrick Johnson on the call tonight, filling in for Jeff Charles.
Patrick Johnson will be doing play-by-play.
Yeah. For the Pirates.
Jeff Charles has laryngitis, if you hadn't heard. Jeff Charles has laryngitis. Patrick Johnson will do play-by-play tonight.
Also in action tonight, number one Duke taking on San Diego State at 4:30. Number seven North Carolina will be hosting St. Francis at 7. Eight other top 25 teams will be in action today. ECU's women, they're now 4-0 on the season. They beat Kennesaw State Sunday 68-56. And on the track, Joey Logano won the season finale Sunday at Homestead Miami Speedway to grab his first cup championship. And you mentioned high school football, South Central playing this week. D.H. Conley with a big win. They'll take on Cleveland on Friday night. South Central will take on Southview.
The Browns? They're taking on the Cleveland Browns?
No, just Cleveland.
Cleveland County?
Just Cleveland.
I was going to say Conley might actually be able to beat the Browns.
And then Edenton will also be in action. Now they beat the Falcons this weekend.
Oh, that's true. Well, now they've got, what's his name, the new quarterback. They finally brought the Oklahoma kid in.
Yeah, Baker Mayfield.
How about all the talk about our man Lincoln Riley going to the Dallas Cowboys? And I'm thinking to myself, it was just a few short months ago I was playing golf with this guy. And he's going to the Dallas Cowboys now?
Well,
do you think it's going to happen?
No.
I do. You know, I was watching the Oklahoma game on the weekend.
But it wouldn't surprise me if it does.
They were talking about all the NFL coaches that have come to Norman, Oklahoma, to learn about Riley's offensive strategies.
Yeah, I believe that.
Well, why would you think he wouldn't get a shot?
I'm not saying he's not going to get a shot.
Cowboys won yesterday, so.
Yeah, well, believe it or not, they're kind of back in the playoff hunt. I mean, they could end up being first in their division before it's all said and done.
If they don't make the playoffs,
Garrett's probably gone then. Yeah.
You know, what's his name down there is going to fire what's his name?
Yeah, Jerry's going to fire Jason.
Jerry's going to fire Jason.
Yeah. Jerry! Come on, Jerry!
So. 8:39, 21 minutes in front of 9. That's our sports update. Courtesy of Trent McGee and courtesy of our friends at Country Mart Stores here in Eastern North Carolina, our friend Smitty, Kenneth Smith, and the great folks at Country Mart and Smitty's Restaurant. You know what? I just got up this morning at like 5 o'clock and had a quick bowl of cereal, and I was thinking after the show this morning, I might ride out to Smitty's and get a sausage biscuit.
Mm.
Maybe a sausage and cheese biscuit. Maybe a sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit. Mm. So, Pat, if you're listening, have it ready at 9:15. So
that would be good.
Two locations, a Country Mart in Pitt County. One, of course, just outside Greenville on Highway 11 between Greenville and Bethel, where Smitty's Restaurant is, where you get good, great home cooking every day for lunch. I'm telling you, man, if you haven't had lunch with Pat at Smitty's, you don't know what you're missing. It is some of the best food you will ever put in your mouth. I love Smitty's Restaurant. And, of course, they also have food. They don't have the full grill like they do out on Highway 11 on the 903 in Stokes, but they do have pizza. They got dogs and hot dogs and hamburgers and stuff like that at Country Mart in Stokes. And, of course, Country Mart, the home of Gulf products now. And they've got that that gas that's best for your engines, that ethanol-free, 100% ethanol-free gas that's great for your boat engines, great for your lawnmowers, and all sorts of small engines. Stop by and see Kenneth Smith. Stop by and see Pat at Smitty's. Smitty's Restaurant and Country Mart bring us our sports update at 20 minutes now in front of 9 o'clock. Let's get a break in. When we come back, now we're going to talk about the Turkey Trot, which is coming up on Thursday morning here in Greenville. Get ready to get up and get exercising. Get those, get that blood pumping on Thursday morning before you start eating turkey and filling up your system with Liptotran. What is it? Liptotripsy. What is it?
Yeah, that too.
Liptotripsy is the thing they do with the kidneys, isn't it?
Oh, okay.
Liptotran? What is that called?
You got to get it. I'm going to agree with you, so you got to get it right.
What is it?
I don't know. I'm just going to agree with what you're saying.
Tryptophan. Tryptophan.
I don't know.
That stuff that makes you sleepy when you eat turkey. I don't know what it is. I just know it always makes me want to take a nap on the couch. 19 in front of 9. We'll be right back.
What would happen if I had to pick up the phone, call 911 for one of my family members or one of my neighbors? What would I do if no one was on the other end to respond? What if there was no 911? You can be a part of the solution.
Anybody can be a firefighter, male, female, younger, older.
We are school teachers. We are leaders in business.
Is me, you, anyone that wants to be.
There is no typical firefighter.
You waited for year-end savings. Now it's finally here at Greenville Toyota. Camrys, only $179 a month. You don't want to miss these deals. Camrys, $179 during the year-end savings event at Greenville Toyota.
Carolina's greatest hits play all day on 107.9 WNCT.
Don't stop believing.
All your favorites. With Mark, Mark, and Laura in the morning. Carolina's greatest hits play here.
WNCT.
This is the Pepsi for serious fans. Mmm. And serious eats. Oh, yeah. Like Carolina pulled pork, carnitas, or Alberto's al pastor. Nice, Beto. This is the Pepsi for Sundays at the ballpark and days off at your favorite joint. Whatever you're craving, this is the Pepsi for you.
Stop by Moore's Old Time Barbecue and grab a Carolina Classic combo with a free 20-ounce Pepsi. Moore's Barbecue and Pepsi, Carolina Classics indeed.
Sometimes coming home can be a battle in itself. Our wounded warriors need everyone's support to meet the challenges they face every day. The USO provides every American a way to support them and their families.
What?
It's good to be back.
Join us. Visit USO.org to learn how you can make a difference in the lives of our wounded warriors. The USO. Until everyone comes home.
Don't wait. Get year-end savings now at Greenville Toyota. Corollas, $159 a month. RAV4s, $199. The wait is over and the deals won't last. It's the year-end savings event at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
Okay, Thanksgiving morning is the annual turkey trot here in Greenville. I've done this a few years. I won't be there this year, unfortunately, because I'm going to be out of town. But it's a fun event, and it's a good way to start your Thanksgiving morning rather than lay around in the bed and start eating, which a lot of people tend to do, including yours truly. You can eat later in the day, but get up and get some exercise. It's the Turkey Trot for Tots coming up, sponsored by the Bose Buddies Group here in Greenville on Thursday morning, Thanksgiving morning. Here to talk about that is Marcy Parker from Bose Buddies. Good morning. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
It's good to see you. It's good to see you.
Thank you. We'd like to thank you and WTIB for having us on this morning.
Hey, it's great. It's great to have you. I understand you've already run the school bus to six different schools this morning and in the rain. So
I have. It's a fun event.
Hey, super mom, and you made it here for the radio interview. How about that?
Barely. I'm here.
All right, let's talk about it. Tell us, first of all, for people who don't know what Bose Buddies is, what is Bose Buddies?
Bose Buddies is a nonprofit organization that raises money to help children fight cancer. Mm-hmm. They give back money to families that are in need for events such as if they need a gas card, if they need help, whatever they need help with during their time of struggle, we give back to those families.
Right. And it's been a great organization for many years. And what I love about it is it's local. And all the money stays local and helps local people.
Absolutely, it
does.
That's
what I love about it. And one of the things you do to raise money every year is Thanksgiving morning. You have the Turkey Trot, which is a great event here in Greenville. And I just looked at the weather. And Thanksgiving morning, you are going to have perfecto weather.
It should be absolutely beautiful.
It's going to be nice. So tell us the details. What is the Turkey Trot?
So the Turkey Trot will have a 5K and will also have a fun run for children. It will be at the registration is going to be up until midnight on the 20th, which is tomorrow. And then Wednesday we'll have the package pickup at Moe's from 5 to 8.
Moe's on Red Banks?
Absolutely, yes, yeah. Sir. And they'll be able, we'll open back up registration that night if they would like to do that.
Okay.
Registration will start the morning, Thursday morning at 6:30, so you can just walk up. A lot of times we have people that are in town. They're just visiting with family.
Right.
They can come register at 6:30.
Bring your cousins and your uncles.
Absolutely.
And your aunts.
The race starts at 8 o'clock in the morning, and then the fun run will start at approximately 8:45, and it's in the cul-de-sac behind the Hilton.
Yeah, everybody just gathers right behind the Hilton Hotel, and that little cul-de-sac back there works out good.
Yes, we have a DJ.
And they usually have some juice and coffee and stuff like that.
Donuts, yes.
Yeah, donuts. Mm-hmm. So you have a donut, then you go run.
I'd get the donut after you ran.
Some people actually do that. I've seen them eat the donuts and then run.
They
not me. I can't.
Maybe
do
it gives them a sugar rush, a little bolt in the morning.
How far is the run? I mean, I know you go through my old neighborhood back there in West Haven, but how far is it? Do you know how far it is?
It's a 5K, and I am not a runner.
Well, that's what I was asking. It's a 5K.
It's a 5K.
I think that's about.
Is it three?
About 3 miles?
Yes.
3 miles,
I think. A little over 3 miles, I think.
I just remember I did it two or 3 years ago, and I nearly died.
I don't want to run. I'll be doing the fun run with my children, and they'll run, and I walk behind them
to make
sure
they're safe. Well, I actually was the last. Ray Spears and I were the last people to arrive at the finish line 3 years ago, and we got a huge round of applause. Because we were still breathing.
That's nice. Well, we have medals for the winners in each age category.
Yeah.
The entry fee, I want to go over that in case we have people show up at the last minute. For the 5K for an adult, it's $30 plus a toy. We'll have a van there, a place that they can put their toys. For anyone 13 to 17, it's $25 plus a toy. For 12 and under, it's $20 plus a toy. And for the fun run, it's $10. And the toys will be delivered to the Children's Hospital for Christmas.
Awesome. Great, great stuff. So, again, if you want to learn more, I think there's some information on Facebook, on the Bose Buddies Facebook page, isn't there?
There is, and I just got a text. It's 3.1 miles.
3.1 miles. I was close.
3.1.
I could have made it the 3 miles. It was the 0.1 that almost made me throw up.
I couldn't make it 3 miles, I think. So, absolutely. Yeah.
All right, so it is this Thursday morning, Thanksgiving morning. Again, you can register at Moe's on Red Banks Road up until Wednesday night.
Yeah, well, we're going to close off registration at midnight on Tuesday.
Oh, Tuesday night.
Mm-hmm. Okay, they'll have package pickup on at Moe's from 5 to 8 on Red Banks.
Okay.
And I'm sure
it's just
the
package pickup at Moe's.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure if you tell them there that you would like to register, they will absolutely take your registration.
And then do what I always do, just show up that morning, but get there early enough to register.
Absolutely. Yeah. If you have not registered, 6:30 is when you can start registering, and I'll be at the registration table.
And what does it cost?
It's $30 for an adult. It's $25 from 13 to 17, and it's $20 for 12 and under.
Right.
And then it's $10 for the fun run. And if there are shirts left over after package pickup, then people that register that morning will also get a shirt.
You get a T-shirt. And again, coffee and donuts and juice at the and again, just gather.
Sir.
Behind the Hilton off Greenville Boulevard, just off Landmark Street there.
Absolutely.
And in the cul-de-sac back there. And it's kind of a fun thing because everybody's out there Thanksgiving morning. And
it is fun.
It's a fun deal. It really is. I enjoy it. I'm sorry I'm going to miss it this year. If I was in town, I would do it, but I'm not going to be. So I will designate my surrogate, Mr. McGee, to represent me at this year's fun.
Next year I'll prepare. Maybe I can try to run with you and walk in at the last
there you
minute.
Go. All right, Marcy. Thank you.
Thanks.
All right, I'll get McGee to mention this some more as we head toward Thursday as well.
Perfect.
Thank you. Appreciate
thank
it.
You.
All right, it's 8:51, 9 minutes in front of 9 o'clock. We'll redo our Thanksgiving laugh track coming up next here on Talk of the Town. Be right back.
Save with low monthly payments on new Jeep here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
It's the Black Friday sales event. Lease a new 2019 Jeep Cherokee for only $299 a month. With only $299 due at signing. Lease a new Jeep Grand Cherokee for only $399 a month. With only $399 due at signing. Or lease a new Jeep Wrangler for only $399 a month. With only $399 due at signing.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Space, you can't run down to the store to buy parts. You have to improvise with what you have on your mission. Making is when there is something new that was not in existence at the beginning of the day.
Okay.
It's an incredible sense of accomplishment when you have made something. That's why I make. Now I want to hear why you make.
Share your own Why I Make story today. Visit whyimake.org.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is the truck dealer in Eastern North Carolina. We are overloaded with new Ram trucks, and we've discounted every one of them to move.
Save up to $12,000 in total savings on select Ram 1500 trucks right now at the Summer Clearance Event. And come test drive the all-new 2019 Rams that are now here in stock.
Visit us at WashingtonChrysler.com. Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Drive a little to save a lot.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
Come check out the all-new 2019 Ram. We have a huge selection to choose from here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Hurry in to the Black Friday sales event for huge rebates and super low lease payments on Ram trucks. Right now, get a total savings of $12,659 or lease a new 2019 Ram 1500 Crew Cab for only $379 a month with only $999 due at signing.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Talk of the Town here this morning on the 19th day of November. Welcome back, 103.7 WTIB here in this hour. And happy birthday to you if you're having a birthday today on the 19th of November. you're having a some famous people having birthdays today. Larry King. Hello, you're on, Washington. Hello, Washington, you're on. 85 years old, Larry King, today. One of Larry King's predecessors in the famous talk show world, Dick Cavett, 82 years old today. Actress Meg Ryan is 57. Who did I see Meg Ryan is marrying? Google, Michael. Meg Ryan married who? She just married somebody famous. She's 57. Jodie Foster is 56 today, and Adam Driver is 35 years old today. McGee's already gone, so I have to have you Google it, Michael. Any luck?
Dennis Quaid? That doesn't sound right.
No, that's right. No, she was married to Dennis Quaid. I think they are divorced. I think Jodie Foster just married somebody else. I mean,
yeah, she did.
Meg Ryan just married somebody else, I thought. Anyway, happy birthday to her, no matter who she's married to.
Yeah, divorced in 2001.
Yeah.
I saw John Mellencamp.
Yes, that's right. Who it is. She's marrying John Mellencamp. John Cougar. Why did he drop the Cougar, by the way?
I think he went with his real name. I think that's his real name.
It's something about him wanting to honor his roots and his Indiana farm family and all that stuff.
Yeah, I think so.
Said he wished he'd never started with the name John Cougar.
Cougar's a neat name.
I don't see him and Meg Ryan as a good couple, do you?
No. She looks 57, he looks about 104. Looks really old.
You know, here's the thing, though. I mean, both of their careers is kind of over. Although Cougar could tour and still fill up arenas.
Yeah.
Meg Ryan still. I haven't seen her in a movie in a long time.
And his new album is horrible.
Well, I mean, most of the new albums are horrible. No. All those new albums you've told me about.
No, that is not
every,
true.
Every time we mention a famous artist, they got a new album. They all have a new album,
no,
but their career is over.
They don't have new albums, all of them.
Let me give you the information again about our Embers Christmas show. I really want people to grab your tickets this week because we are hoping to sell this thing out this year and raise a lot of money for Operation Santa Claus. Every single dime of the ticket price that you pay will go to the kids in Eastern North Carolina who need Christmas gifts that otherwise probably won't get them. So, you know, not only can you come to the Ember Show, enjoy a great show, but you're also going to be doing something for another great family here in Eastern North Carolina that needs your help this Christmas through Operation Santa Claus. It's December 9, Sunday night, December 9th, 7 o'clock at Reimage Church here in Greenville. Please come out. Tickets are $20 for adults. 10 and under are free. And you can get tickets at Steinbeck's Men's Shop. They are available right now at Steinbeck's Men's Shop on Arlington Boulevard. Stop into Steinbeck's and get some tickets, or you can go to eventbrite.com and get tickets. And that link is on our Facebook page. You can go to my Facebook page and get the Embers link to the tickets, or you can go to any of our web pages. Our website's WTIBFM.com or 1079WNCT.com or 943TheGame.com. Get your tickets for the Embers December 9th. Thanks to our great sponsors, Taft Office Equipment, Steinbeck's Men's Shop, Suddenlink, Greenville Utilities, and Fantastic Sam's. Those are our sponsors for the Ember Show on December the 9th. All right, let's do our laugh track. We're redoing the Thanksgiving laugh track. The great former... A comedian, the late Kevin Meaney, with a great Thanksgiving message here this morning.
They're always having company coming over. You know, that was a big thing. We're having company tonight. So stay out of the bathroom. Stay out of that bathroom. We've got company coming over. Where are we supposed to go? I don't care. Just regulate yourself. Wait till they leave. Thanksgiving was another big day when we were kids, you know. We'd have the big turkey every year. Last year, the turkey weighed 185 pounds. It had a tattoo. Riding around the front lawn on a Harley. Took my sister hostage for 24 hours. My Uncle Zeke actually had to put on his flame-retardant pilgrim suit and subdue him with a flamethrower. He was always dressing up for Thanksgiving. One year, he dressed up as a butterball turkey. And my Aunt Rose couldn't stop talking about it. Oh, my God. Look at Zeke dressing up like a butterball turkey. I can't believe. Look at him sitting in that roasting pan wearing go-go boots.
pouring gravy on his torso with a big old ladle. He's going to get arrested for public self-basting. Just like he did last year. Look where he's got the thermometer.
Kevin Meaney on the Lab Track. All right, don't forget ECU basketball here in the Coliseum tonight at 7 o'clock. And, hey, if you miss it on 107... 107-